Good morning everyone. We are back in our digital class for class 9th, and today we are going to study more about chapter 5. Introduction part I have already done for you. Now in chapter 5, if you move to page number 18, here equivalent definition, axiom and postulate is given. So what is equivalent definition? So I told you equivalent give a book that name as element. That book have 13 chapters and that chapters referred about the geometric concepts. Now where he exposes the 23 definitions in book number 1 element. So few of the definition is given or mentioned in class 9th. The first axiom, a point is that which has no part. It means what is a point and why we use point. So a point is a tip of pencil. This is referred as capital letter, and this point is used to show exact location. As like in maps, if a unfilled map is given to you and anybody asks you to mark Delhi, then you just put a point where Delhi is located and put that point and write Delhi. It means that point refers to Delhi. So what is a point? So point is a tip like structure with a pencil or pen that has no part. It means we cannot split a point. Now next, a line has breadthless length. The second definition is told about line, and the definition is a line is breadthless length. It means if we talk about line, so here it is a line AB. AB line has only length. If we talk about line AB, so what AB refers? AB refers the length, not breadth, because it is not an area. If anything is represented at area, then we call it a length and breadth. But line has no area, so it has no breadth. It has only length. Okay, students. Now move to the third one. The third is the end of a line are points. If you want to end a line, so if you take a line as here, it has two end points, so we name as A, B or PQ or RS, and this is not a line, it is called as line segment. So it has two points. Okay, a line segment has also two points, and line also have two points. What is difference between this line and this line segment? This line refers to lengthless direction. It has infinitely lengthy. We can move in any one of the direction and it will be movable. But this is a line segment. It has definite length. Here the length is exact, will not be reduced at any rate, and it has two end points. And these are the end points in the previous one. No, these are not the end point, but these are the points. These are the end points. Okay, students. Now we are going to move on the fourth one. The straight line is a line which lie evenly with the points on itself. It means if we talk about a straight line, this one is straight. It means in a straight line, if we talk about a point, we talk about another point which is M. So if we talk about, as M is on the point, or M is a point on line PQ, it means that M is also on a straight line, on that line, not above the line, not below the line. Now move to fifth one. A surface is that which has length and breadth only. What is surface? If we want to define a surface, so what is surface? Surface is that which is only length and breadth. What it means? It means surface has only two dimensions. First is length and breadth. If we talk about this paper, so this paper has length and breadth only. It has no height, no depth. When we talk about this board, so this board is utilized as only length and breadth. This height we are not calculating. So if we want to talk about the surface must be only two things. First is length and second is breadth. It has no height. As like line has no breadth, as like surface has no height. Now move to next one. This one was regarding the surface.
sixth definition is about the edge of a surface or line. Okay, firstly I want to take a thing which has edge. When we talk about this book has edges. What is an edge known as? The edge where two surfaces meet. Where two surfaces meet, if you want to take this one, so this one is an edge because two surfaces is meet at that point. And if you want to see a box like a structure, where the box is going to folded, where the surface is going to folded in box, that folded portion is known as the length and breadth. It means that is the end point of the surface. So surface has only a length and breadth. Sorry, I am deflected somewhere else. So the edges of surfaces are line. Okay, now I'm going to try once more. If you want to see the room, okay, if you want to see the room, so this wall and the adjacent wall, both wall is joined by a corner. That's corner line known as edge. If you want to see, I want to move this camera to this hand. Okay, now at the place of door you can see the edge. This is called the edge. Okay students, now move to the next and the seventh one definition. The seventh one definition is a plane surface is a surface which lies evenly with the straight line on itself. Now it's when we talk about the plane surface, on a plane surface we are able to make squares, we are able to make circles, we are able to make curve, we are able to make a whole figure which is referred to two dimensions. If anybody asks us to make a 3D figure, so we can give an idea, but we are not able to make the exact 3D figure. That figure is not exact 3D figure. This is that was only the idea of the 3D figure. Because when I teach this certain definition in class, the student asks me usually, so I am able to make this keyboard figure. So is this not a 3D figure? So I can tell you, this is only an idea. What is 3D? In our previous video, I am talking about all the solids which we have caught. Which if we hold this is 3D. Here, with the whole desire, you are not able to hold this figure. You only that rub this figure because this is on two dimensional. If it is a 3D figure, it means you have to move, you can move that figure this place to another one. If a book is placed on the table, so if you want to move that book from here to another place, now you take this book and put it anywhere else. But if you want to move this figure, you cannot move. Why we cannot move that figure? Because this is not a solid figure. This is only an idea of 3D figure. So it means if you want to stretch lines on a plane surface, so you are able to make only and only lines, straight line on a or a curved line structure on a plane surface, not a 3D figure. It means a plane surface is never referred to a 3D figure. Now we can move to the next portion, which is known as axiom. Firstly, I want to make a difference between axiom and postulate, because here we have to study about two things. Firstly, you have to read the whole topic, the whole scenario, and then you can create your own mind. But if you want to depend on me, then I am giving you an idea of what is axiom and what is postulate. So here we have two things, axioms and postulate. What is difference between axiom and postulates? First of all, axioms means a rule which refer the concept, that axiom can be used at any place of mathematics, in a simple manner, in a general example, in a mathematic, and we can use that rule in else about the mathematics also. When we want to use that rule in our daily life, we can use that rule also in our daily life. But in postulate, it refers only mathematics and a special kind of mathematics, that known as geometry. It means we have two portions in mathematics. First is axioms and second is postulate. Axiom can be used as arithmetic, as algebra, as any other kind of mathematic values. But when we talk about the postulate, that postulate is only used to refer a geometrical construction or geometrical things or geometrical sum. We are not able to use postulate in at any other place. Okay, students. Now we are going to talk about first thing is axiom. What is an axiom? So the rule which we refer to state our statement correct, to make our statement conceptual. So that rule which we give to make our doing our steps correct, that known as axiom. Okay, students, and that not refer in geometry only, that can be referred at any place. We have already used axioms in chapter 1st, in chapter 2nd, and in many chapters, but we are not referred as like axiom. But in geometry, if we refer that rule, so we have to possess that rule as axiom, or that doing what we have done to relate with the axiom. Okay, students, now if you want to know more about the axiom and postulate, so here I want to read about a para. That para is on page number 81, the second para. Starting with his definition, Euclid assumed certain properties which were not to be proved. It means some property is not going to be proved fully. So that assumption are actually obvious universal truth. So we can make that reference as universal truth. We cannot prove that, but that thing is existed in our nature. So we call it universal truth. After that, we divided them in two types. So we divided that property which we cannot prove, but those are universal truth, in two types. First one is axiom and second one is postulate. We use term postulate for assumption that were specific to geometry. What I have told you, that postulate is only used or only assumed about the geometry, but common notation is known as axiom. Common notation means it can be used at any place. Okay, students, now we are moving to equivalent axioms. We have many of the axioms, but here we only talk 7 axioms. And these axioms are known as universal truth, and this can be used at any place. The first axiom: things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. It means if we have taken two or more things, then, or more than two things, then we have three things: first A, second B, and third C. If A is equal to B, so here I am telling you A is equal to B, and B is also equal to C. Here, the first thing is A is equal to B, and B is equal to C. So we can look at the equation first. Now, students, you are able to give the answer. If A is equal to B and B is equal to C, so we can say that A is equal to C. Which type of property we have used? So we have used axiom number first. Things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. If you are a student of class 9A and the other person is also a student of class 9A, it means you both are a student of class 9A. That refers. Okay, students, it means if A equal to 100 and B equal to 100, it means A and B are equal, because both A and B are equal to 100. So it is clear, when two things are equal to a common thing, then the both two things are equal. Things which are equal to the same thing is another person. The things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. It means if Ram has 100 rupees, if Shyam has 100 rupees, it means the money held by both person are equal. It means both are equal. Okay, students, that is used in at any place. We are usually use this property to equate the equation. Okay, students, I have told you in many of the sum which we have taught in our previous chapters, to equate sum we are using that property. Okay, now the next one. Very interesting. If equal are added to equal, the wholes are equal. What that mean? That means if two person have equal money, I think I am taking two physical example. First one is known as Ram and second one is known as Shyam. Now both person have 100 rupees. If one person, as like me, I want to give Ram 2 rupees and Shyam 2 rupees. After adding these 2 rupees, the both have same amount of rupees, that known as 102. What it means? It means that if two things are already equal, if two things are already equal, and if we add the same number to both, then the answer after adding is also be equal. So why we use this thing? It is very simple, since it seems very simple when we use arithmetic sum, but in geometry we have to relate that sum very frequent manner. So the second one is also done. If equals are added to equal, it means two things are equal, and when we add equal amount of things in those things, then after adding the answer will be equal. Now third one refer to, if equals are subtracted from equal, then if equal are subtracted from equal, the remainders are equal. It means two persons have equal amount of money. It means A person has 500 rupee, B person has 500 rupee. They both live in different places. They are going to their native place and spent 200 rupees as fare of taxi. And how much amount they have left? They have left 300 rupees each. It means if two person have equal amount of money and they spend equal amount of money to their expenditure, after subtracting the money they have expended, what is left, both are equal. It means two things have equal already. When we subtract equal amount of things from both side, then the answer will be equal. That was the third number exam. Now move to the fourth number exam. What is fourth number exam, students? Now fourth number exam, things which are coincide with another are equal to one another. Now this property, I want to give the example with the help of two papers. Things which are coincide with another. What is the means of coincide? Firstly, coincide. Here, a keyword coincide. Coincide. It means over. So I have two paper. This one, which is on right hand known as A, and this which is on left hand known as B. Is both paper are equal? Without measurement we are not able to say both paper are equal or not. So what we do, we take a paper as like and put the next paper on it and make all corners equal, as like they are overlap on one another. When we move it on other side, else also the both are equal. It means if two things coincide, it means when we put a thing overlap on the other thing and both thing coincide one another, that means the both things are equal. So what is the means of the fourth number of property? And it will use in very frequently. If you have two types of pen, first pen is blue pen and second pen is black pen, and both pen are Trimex, it means both men are of same company. When we put or interchange the cap of one to another, that the first cap is fitted to the next man and the second cap is fitted to the first one. If you want to take two Trimex men, one is of red color, one is of blue color, you can overlap their pen to one another. We can take, put out the pen of cap of the first pen and put on the second one, and second cap to the first one, both cap are equal. Why? Because their lengths are equal, their dimensions are equal. If two things overlap each other, it means they are equal. So here it is, if two things coincide, matlab things which are coincide with one another are equal to one another, matlab agar if you manage to coincide both things together, if they coincide each other, it means both are equal. Here one or two words I have used in Hindi, so ignore it. Now the next one, the whole is greater than the part. What that means? We have done whole is greater than a part. If we have a chalk, this is a chalk. If you want to take a small piece of chalk from it, this is a part of this chalk. After splitting this chalk, one of the chalk, any one of them, is bigger than the whole one. So answer will be no. If we split a part from the whole, the portions, one of them is larger portion, one of them is smaller portion, but both portion are smaller than the previous one before splitting. Because if we split a whole in two part, Always the whole is greater, not their parts are not greater than the whole part. It is a universal truth. If you have 500 rupees, if you donate that 499 to a person, and if you donate 1 rupee to other person, the both make 500. If they both used to make 500, then their parts will not be greater than 500. Why their part will not be greater than 500? Because whole is always greater than a part. Now, what about the sixth number axiom? This number six axiom: things which are double of the same thing are equal to one another. It means if you take two things together and both are equal, as like you have two persons and both have 100 rupees, if you make their amount double, after doubling the both are equal. It means if two things are equal, after doubling the both are also be equal after double. Okay, here
the sixth one is completed. Now talk about the seventh one.
If two things are given and both are equal, if you make half of those, then the remainder parts or the remaining parts are also equal. If you have two sticks of 10 cm, if you cut that between the midpoint, you have two sticks. Okay, you cut down the sticks from the midpoint, and the remaining part of that stick are 5 cm and 5 cm, and both parts are equal. Actually, these examples are referred to physical examples. If you want to take a physical example, you can understand about that. The things which are half of the same thing, or whatever it is, things which are the half of the same thing are equal to one another. If you take two equal part and do half of those, after doing half, the remaining parts are also equal. Okay, students. Now here I have done all the seven exams. I want to revise that exam again. The first one is things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. The second one, if equals are added to equal, the wholes are equal. The third one, if equals are subtracted from equal, the remainders are equal. The fourth one, things which are coincide with one another are equal to one another. The next one, the whole is greater than the part. Sixth one, things which are double of the same thing are equal to one another. And the last one, things which are half of the same thing are equal to one another. And I want to give you some suggestion. The first suggestion, you have to write this exam in your notebook after writing the definition which I have taught previous in the previous part of this video. After that, when you will write the exam in your exams, you are not allowed to write that exam in your language. Why we are not suggested to write that in our own language? Because those are the statements, and those statements are stated by the Euclid, and if anybody has stated the statement, that statement we have to take in as usual condition, not we have to trim that, not we have to rewrite that. Okay, so we have to write the whole exam as usual condition. Okay students, we can't able to change the statements. So learn this frequently. As like, then if anybody asks you which exam you have used, so you have answer to give the exams. Okay, and now we are going to move about the postulates. If you want to know more about exam, so you have to revise all the things which is given after the exam: the common notation, the preferences, the fourth exam, about the fifth exam. Okay, now move to the postulates. How many postulates we have? Firstly, what is postulate? Postulate. Before postulate, I want to say that in exam, we can use that exam or we can refer that exam at any place of mathematics. But in postulate, we use the universal truth statement only and only in geometrical condition. Now, first postulate. So what is postulate? Postulate is universal truth that we use only in geometry. Okay, the first postulate: a straight line may be drawn from any one point to any other point. If means you want to make a line, then you have to prefer two points, only two points, and you can manage. Firstly, take two points, put ruler, and join these points.
If you join these points, then you have a line.
It means only two points is required to make a line.
No need to take more than two points. If you have two points P and Q, take a ruler, join these points P and Q, then we have a line.
Only a straight line can be drawn from one point to any other point. It means only two points is required to make a straight line. Now, second, a terminated line. What the mean of terminated line?
The second keyword is like coincide. Terminated line. What is terminated line? Terminated line refer as line segment. So, okay, terminated line is known as line segment.
In nowadays we are called terminated line as line segment, but this statement stated before 15 or 1600 years ago or 2000 years ago.
So at that time we are not talking about line segment. At that time we call that line segment with a special name, that is terminated line. What the meaning of terminated? I have already told you in chapter first, terminus, which we have ends, which have ends. So this terminated line has A and B. We can produce this line in both directions. If we require, if we have any requirement, then we can produce this line in direction B or in direction A. So where it be used? First of all, where it can be used? It can be used as like you have a triangle. What is a triangle? A polygon with three line segments. So it has three line segments. Line segments, terminated line. But if you want to make an extreme angle, so we can move or we can produce BC to direction D or CB to direction D. We can move in either directions. So whether it is a terminated line, it is a line segment. It cannot be produced, but it can be produced if we want to produce. In many of the some we do construction. At the place of construction, what property we have used? We have used the second postulate of terminated line can be produced indefinitely. So why we use that property? We can use the things as we want, but no. We only use that property in our construction which is referred by the postulates. If you do a sum as like you want, at what condition you can examine the way you have done the sum is correct or not correct. So for examination you have to know about the postulate. Just whatever you do it as construction, you have to manage or compare that construction step with the postulate. If that construction steps resemble with any of the postulate, it means you are correct. And if your construction step is not resemble with any postulate step, then you are incorrect. Okay, now move to the third postulate, that a circle can be drawn with any center and any radius. It means we can draw a circle with only two things. First is the center and second is the radius. Circle is drawn. Okay, so it is as simple, the postulate number third, a circle can be drawn with any center and any radius. It is not required to know more than two things for a circle. To make a circle, you have only know about two things. First is the center and second is the radius. Now, move to the fourth one. All right angles are equal to one another. Why we use this type of property? We already know that right angle has 90 degree angle. So why we use this property? This property is used to refer RHS property of congruency. In congruency, we usually use that PQR and ABC, angle Q equal to angle B, each 90. So here we refer each 90. Why we refer each 90? Because all properties are equal. From where we know about that property? We knew about that property by the postulate number 4, because all right angles are equal to one another. As like if we make a right angle in figure 1 and if we make right angle in figure 2, if
and both figure have a right angle, it means both right angles are equal. Now last but not the least, the postulate number 5.
That postulate number 5 refer you about the parallel lines.
What the parallel lines? What that postulate means?
If you take two lines, as like, firstly I want to
read that postulate. If a straight line falling on two straight line, the interior angle on the same side is taken together less than two right angle, then two straight line is produced, it meet on that side where sum is less than two right angle. So here we have two lines, L, M,
and a straight line falling on these two lines. What that concept mean? The whole concept means transversal concept. There is a name, special name in class 7th, parallel transversal. So what that property mean? That property mean when a straight line falling on two straight line. It means if two straight line falling as parallel, if we put a straight line on the parallel line, that one is parallel transversal. But when a line putting on two lines, straight lines, has any condition, that is known as transversal set.
But if those lines are parallel, that known as parallel transversal set. So here
we have two pair of interior angles. These two pairs refer more than 90. So here I can take A and B. This A and B is refer sum of more than two right angles. So if you will add A and B, it will be more than one. How can we say? So if we want to make a right angle, this could be as that. So here this is more than right angle, and here it is also more than right angle. Okay, so these two parts, if we take it together, that gives us the answer more than two right angle. As like more than two right angle means more than 180. If a figure refer us exact 180, then the lines are parallel. But if those are not give us exact 180, it will give us less than 180 or more than 180. It means the lines are not parallel. And if we produce that line may be intersected in line at any point.
And here these two parts, it is less than,
if you take together, it is less than
what?
It is less than 180. It means here 180 is less than 3 plus t. Now I want to make you more understandable. If we take this thing in our parallel line, it means here both make 180, and on other hand it also make equal to 180, and that refers a property which known as co-interior angle. Consecutive interior sum is 180, but in this condition here the sum is not equal to 180. Here A and B gives us more than 180, and C and D, which when we add together, gives us less than 180. So when we have two conditions, first is less than 180 and second is more than 180. Now produce these lines in both directions. Here the portion is increases, but on the other hand, these portions are decreases and meet. And at which portion it meets? It meets at the portion C and D where X meet. Where C and D is placed, at that direction they meet. Why they meet at that direction?
Because it is stated in our postulate. Now I am going to read the postulate once again to make you more understandable. So, if a straight line falling on two straight lines make the interior angle on the same side of it taken together less than two right angle. So here it is less than two right angle. C plus D is given as less than two right angle. Okay. Then the two straight line is produced indefinitely. So these two lines are produced in both directions indefinitely. They meet on that side. So they meet on that side where the sum of angles less than two right angle. Where the sum is less than two right angle at the place of C and D. When we produce this line on that direction, then they will meet. So here I have completed Here I have completed the whole concept of postulate and axiom. What is axiom? Axiom is a universal truth that can be referred at any place of mathematics. And what are postulate? Postulate are a special kind of special truth, but they are used in only in a specific type of geometry. Okay students, you have to learn both of the things, axioms and postulate. And after that we are able to do the sum of this chapter. And in our next video we will talk about the chapter. Thank you. Take care.